Welcome to the presentation on dividing fractions. Let's get started. So before I give you the intuition, I might do that in a different module. I'm just going to show you the mechanics of how you divide a fraction. And it turns out that it's actually not much more difficult than multiplying fractions. If I were to ask you 1/2 divided by 1/2, whenever you divide by a fraction, or actually when you divide by any number, it's the same thing as multiplying by its inverse. So 1/2 divided by 1/2 is equal to 1/2 times 2 over 1. We just inverted inverse the second 1/2. And we know from the multiplication module, 1/2 times 2 over 1, well, that's just equal to 2 over 2, or it's equal to 1. And that makes sense, because actually any number divided by itself is equal to 1. 1/2 divided by 1/2 is 1, just like 5 divided by 5 is 1, just like 100 divided by 100 is 1. And this isn't a new principle. Actually, you are always doing it. Think about it this way. What is 2 divided by 2? Well, you know that's 1. But isn't this also the same thing as 2 times the inverse of 2, which is 1? I'll show it to you. Let me give you a couple more examples to show that this dividing fractions really isn't a new concept, this whole notion of multiplying by the inverse. If I were to tell you what is 12 divided by 4, well, we know the answer to this, but I'm going to show you that this is the same thing as 12 times 1/4. 12 over 1 times 1 over 4 is 12 over 4. Which is 3. And 12 over 4 is really just another way of writing 12 divided by 4. So it's kind of a long way of getting to the same point. But I just wanted to show you that what we're doing in this module is nothing new than what we've always been doing when we divide by a number. Division is the same thing. Dividing by a number is the same thing as multiplying by the inverse of that number. And just as a review, an inverse, if I have a number A, the short for inverse, is 1 over A. So the inverse of 2/3 is 3/2. Or the inverse of 5, because 5 is the same thing as 5 over 1, so the inverse is 1 over 5. We're just flipping it. We're switching the numerator and denominator. So let's do some fraction division problems. What is 2/3 divided by 5 over 6? Well, we know that this is the same thing as 2/3 times 6 over 5. And that's equal to 12 over 15. And we could divide the numerator and the denominator by 3. That's 4 over 5. What is 7 over 8 divided by 1/4? Well, that's the same thing as 7 over 8 times 4 over 1. Remember, I just flipped this 1/4. Divide by 1/4 is the same thing as multiplying by 4 over 1. That's all you got to do. And then we could use a little shortcut we learned in the multiplication module. 8 divided by 4 is 2. 4 divided by 4 is 1. So that equals 7 over 2. Or if you wanted to write that as a mixed number, this is, of course, an improper fraction. Improper fractions have a numerator larger than a denominator. If you wanted to write that as a mixed number, 2 goes into 7 3 times with a remainder of 1, so that's 3.5. You can write either way. I tend to keep it this way because it's easier to deal with. Let's do a ton of more problems, or at least as many more as we can do in the next 4 or 5 minutes. What's negative 2/3 divided by 5/2? Once again, that's the same thing as minus 2 over 3 times what? It's times the inverse of 5 over 2, which is 2 over 5. And that equals minus 4 over 15. What is 3/2 divided by 1/6? Well, that's just the same thing as 3/2 times 6 over 1, which equals, let's see, this is 3 and a 1. We just divided the 6 by 2 and the 2 by 2, so that equals 9. I think you might be getting it now. Let's see. Let's do a couple more. And of course, you can always pause and look at this whole presentation again, so you can get confused all over again. Let's see. Let's do minus 5 over 7 divided by 10 over 3. Well, this is the same thing as minus 5 over 7 times 3 over 10. I just multiplied by the inverse. That's all I keep doing over and over again. Minus 5 times 3, minus 15. 7 times 10 is 70. If we divide the numerator and the denominator by 5, we get minus 3 over 14. We could have also just done it here. We could have done 5, 2, and we've gotten minus 3 over 14 as well. Let's do one or two more problems. I think you kind of get it, though. Let's say 1 half divided by minus 3. Aha! So what happens when you take a fraction and you divide it by a whole number or an integer? Well, we know any whole number can be written as a fraction. This is the same thing as 1 half divided by minus 3 over 1. And dividing by a fraction is the same thing as multiplying by its inverse. So the inverse of negative 3 over 1 is negative 1 over 3. And this equals negative 1 sixth. Let's do it the other way. What if I had negative 3 divided by 1 half? Same thing. Negative 3 is the same thing as minus 3 over 1 divided by 1 half, which is the same thing as minus 3 over 1 times 2 over 1, which is equal to minus 6 over 1, which equals minus 6. Now let me give you a little bit of intuition of why this works. Let's say I said 2 divided by 1 third. Well, we know that this is equal to 2 over 1 times 3 over 1, which equals 6. So how does 2, 1 third, and 6 relate? Well, let's look at it this way. If I had two pieces of pizza, I have two pieces of pizza. Here's my two pieces of pizza. Right? Two right here. So I have two pieces of pizza. And I'm going to divide them into thirds. So I'm going to divide each pizza into a third. I'll draw a little Mercedes sign. So I'm dividing each pizza into a third, right? How many pieces do I have? Well, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 pizzas. So you might want to sit and ponder that for a little bit, but I think it might make a little bit of sense to you. I will do one more just to tire your brain. If I had negative 7 over 2 divided by 4 ninths, let's pick it negative 4 ninths. Well, that's the same thing as minus 7 over 2 times minus 9 over 4, right? I just multiplied by the inverse of negative 4 ninths. 9 times 7 is equal to negative 7 times negative 9 is positive 63. And 2 times 4 is 8. Hopefully, I think you have a good idea of how to divide by a fraction now. And you can try out the dividing fractions modules. Have fun.